Welcome back to my channel, Merlin Magic and More. Today we are at Thorpe Park for the Fright Nights. Me and Andrew have come over and we'll be bringing you everything Fright Nights. We're going to be starting our day off over on the Swarm. So we've just had a ride on the Swarm. I think it's one of my favourites, but I'll go on stealth and then I'll tell you that's my favourite. But yeah, can never pick between the two of them. I think it's more comfortable. I don't know what they've done with the straps, but for me, I just felt like it wasn't as tight, was it? So now we're heading into the park and yeah, I'm not sure what we're going on next, but you'll soon find out now.
We're about to go on Mr. Monkey's banana boat. Never done it.
I think this is Mr. Monkey. Oh, that's an old sign.
So we've just done one of the most elusive rides here at Thorpe Park, Mr. Monkey's banana ride. It is my first ever time, and because every time I come it's always shut, but yeah, I thought I'd better get on it before it goes, because I feel like its days are numbered. And actually,
it was good fun.
The restraints, not very tight. You're very loose.
Not swing very fast.
No. I thought it would go higher, but yeah. No. So that's one tick off the list. We're now also going to head down towards Saw, but we're going to have a look at the construction of Hyperia on the way down.
Coming in 2024, Hyperia, the UK's tallest and fastest coaster, reaching heights of 236 feet and speeds of over 80 miles per hour. Once you've experienced Hyperia, you'll never fear again.
This is the station building and there's a crane doing summit. Oh my Christ! Oh my God, I just cannot wait for next year. Let me see if I can zoom in a bit more. Look at that track. Amazing, right, let's have a look through one of these holes.
So there is the station building. That now looks complete, as in the steel frames.
I literally can't wait to get on this next year. It is gonna be the best coaster in the UK by none. And that isn't even the highest point. That's incredible.
So we've just done Saw, which is pretty good. And we're now gonna go and fill up our cups. And then it's either going to be Nemesis or Stealth. Time for Nemesis Inferno, and on Stealth, Nemesis, the Saw the Ride, and the Swarm, and Mr. Monkey's Banana Boat Ride. And now we're going to go and grab some food, and then hopefully, not far, we'll be watching the Fright Night shows. So we're now heading over to Stealth to go and watch the, I think it's Creature Campus Splash Mob, which starts at 3 o'clock, and then we're going to try and get on some mazes. So keep on watching, and remember, if you're liking these videos, hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, drop me a comment.
Precious Council speaking, let's show the new students how we celebrate new beginnings, Creature Campus style.
Survival games, which is different to like, well, I think it's the same, but yeah, pretty good. Thumbs up. No queue either. So we're now heading on to Stitches. So we have just been into Stitches Scare Maze, and it's new for 2023. It's actually pretty good. You're in like a toy shop, and then you go through lots of different mazes. There's like the stuffing room, the stitching room, the wrapping room. It was pretty good, to be fair. I don't know what else to say about it, but yeah. There wasn't many actors in there though, I didn't think. But otherwise, yeah, I would call it a 7 out of 10. Trailers was trash. Like, literally, there was no actors in there whatsoever. And then some people in front of us, I don't know what happened, but the actor had to break character, which ruined it a bit. But there was, like, there was no one in the bed. There was just, I don't know. We went to Death's Doors, and that was, like, way better, which is obviously, like, a free scare attraction. And it was a 70-minute wait, so it's just... Yeah.
Not good.
Bit shit. So we've also watched the shows, like the Hell's Angel show, I think it is. We're going to go and try and get a ride on The Walking Dead, and then hopefully by then Morkin Meadow will be open, and then we'll go and try and catch the fire show. So yeah, keep on watching.
Thank you.
meadow. Lots of pumpkins and hay bales.
It's easy to believe as you go by that something didn't move out of the corner of your eye.
He likes scare. Is he like scaring us?
This is different.
You're a witch! Devil! But she never did anything wrong. They burn her at the stake, but not before she had time to poke us.
Woo!
She'll get you!
Better than trailers, and it's free. Oh, it was much better. Just, yeah, 10 out of 10. So that brings it to the end of our day here at Thorpe Park for Fright Nights. It was a fantastic day. The mazes were good, Stitches was good, the survival games was good, trailers was trash, Morecambe Meadow, brilliant, Death Stores, also good. I think it would have been better in the dark, but hey. And we managed to do all of the rides we wanted to.
Yeah, again, my shows as well.
Oh, the shows were actually really good, to be fair. Like the fire, Hell's Angels and the fire show were pretty good. Choreography is amazing. Audio is good. Staging is good. And yeah, so overall, I would give Fright Nights like An 8 out of 10? It was good. Like, after we've been to Avon Valley Theatre, like, they are something else compared to the scare maze that you get here. But we've had a fantastic day. And we'll see you in the next one. And don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!